Nathan, guess where we're at?
Lovely San Francisco, California.
That's right, we're at the Nissan intro of the new 2013 Sentra. And Nissan says this car is more stylish.
Uh-huh.
It's got more technology.
And it gets better gas mileage.
So, the obvious question is,
how good is it?
Let's find out coming up next on the Fast Lane Car. So Nathan, what does it look like?
Looks like a bridge.
No, not the Golden Gate Bridge, the new Nissan Sentra.
Oh, it looks a little bit like the Maxima, the Altima, and just a tiny little bit of the Versa.
Yeah, it's got that family Nissan sedan DNA now. All right, what does it drive like?
That's what we're gonna find out right now.
So you would expect that this car would be priced a lot higher than the outgoing model, but it's not. It actually starts at $15,990, which is $404 less than today's base model. These are prices without destination and handling.
That is a brand new 1.8-liter engine that puts out 130 horsepower and 128 pound-feet of torque. It's also mated to a brand new CVT transmission, and Nissan does build the best CVTs in the biz. So, let's see how fast that combination will get this Sentra from 0 to 60. All right, Nathan, 0 to 60. We've got 130 horsepower, 128 pound-feet of torque. Yeah. We have a CVT. Yeah. And we are at or about sea level, and there's of course two of us in here.
There's a little bit of rain, but we haven't been experiencing that much wheel slippage. I think our extra weight helps keep this car on the ground. But just in case, I put it in sport mode.
Real world testing, folks. All right, Nathan, here we go. See what we can get. CVT is cranking at about 6,500 RPM. It's raining at sea level. There's two of us in here, real world testing. There we go, 10.66. So that's still pretty slow.
It's still pretty slow, but there are two of us. So we found that if you take one body, one of our larger ones, out of the car, a little bit faster, up to a second faster, that's a little bit more realistic.
But once again, this car is built for fuel economy, not built for power or speed, so you're gonna get pretty slow 0-60 times.
That's true. One thing that Nissan says is all brand new, part of the styling, are these LEDs, which are in the front and back of the car. Kind of looks like something from Lexus or even Audi.
Really?
No, not at all.
So this is actually the first time that Bose is available in the Sentra. For the 2013 redesign model, our system engineers worked, you know, hand in hand with the vehicle designers at Nissan to create a customized sound system that really is it sounds great in the vehicle.
You know, Nathan, once upon a time, compact cars were, well, compact. This is not a compact car. Oh my God, there's so much room back here.
This back seat space is the real selling point of this car. It's fantastic. Here's a funny thing. The Nissan Altima, it's actually slightly smaller in the back than this car.
However, the interior is pretty basic would be a good word. There are soft touch materials wherever you look, but there's really no style. It's, you know, it's a commuter car.
Yeah, and to balance out those soft touch materials is a lot of hard plastics too.
New Sentra starts at about 16 and goes to about 20,000. There are four different versions. And perhaps the most interesting thing is it's $400 cheaper than the outgoing model.
Yeah, it's $400 cheaper. Look, guys, if you want the manual option, that's on the cheapest version of this car, and that's only on the cheapest version of this car.
And that's a 6-speed, which we like. Congratulations.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of new technology built into the Sentra. Bluetooth connectivity, Pandora radio. Heck, it'll even read you your text, and you can get navigation as an option. Basically, everything this phone will do, the car will do now, which of course begs the question, well, you know. This car gets 34 miles to the gallon combined. 39 on the highway.
Yeah.
But it doesn't reach that magic 40 number. Only the Elantra does that. And in order to get that 40, there's a special FE version, which costs $400 more. Basically, they stick some undercladding, add a spoiler, give you more aerodynamics.
They also add low rolling resistant tires.
But then you gotta ask yourself, is it worth $400 more for one more MPG? Just so you can say it gets 40 MPG. The new Sentra competes with cars like the Ford Focus, the Toyota Corolla, and even the Chevy Cruze. If you want to see a video where we compare this car to cars like that, just click on the annotation or visit tflcar.com. One of the ways that Nissan is adding value is by making the new Nissan Sentra bigger yet lighter. But the question, of course, is how much bigger? Does Nathan fit?
Oh yeah! It's a big trunk, 17.1 cubic feet. It's bigger than the old one.
So it certainly is, well, more stylish in the eye of the beholder. It does get better fuel economy and there is more technology. But is it more fun to drive?
Ooh, that's a tough one. The old Sentra was kind of fun. The one right before this one, not so much. We need more time with the car to find out.
Before we can give it our TFL buy, at least it, rent it, or forget it. As always, this is Roman.
And Nathan.
See you next time on the Fast Lane Car. Remember, subscribe for a new video
every single day.
How do we do that, Nathan?
We're magic.
See you next time. Hey, Nathan, where is the Sentra made?
The Nissan Sentra? Currently, it's being built in Mexico.
But aren't they going to make it here in America?
They will be making it here in America soon for American consumers. On the surface, these three cars don't look like they compete, but this is a true TFL car mashup, and they actually do compete.
That's right, we have affordable luxury today. What does it take to get into a luxury car? We have three cars that, believe it or not, all cost about $40,000.
Coming up on the Fast Lane Car.